everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss field consolidation curve. The compression characteristics of in-situ soil are different from those obtained from the test conducted on the soil sample. Even undisturbed samples are also slightly disturbed when those are taken. The disturbance causes slight decrease in the slope of the compression curve obtained in the laboratory after conducting a consolidation test. The methods for obtaining the field consolidation curve from the laboratory consolidation curve are discussed separately for normally consolidated, over-consolidated and under-consolidated soils. So first we will discuss field consolidation curve for normally consolidated soil. So in this graph, void ratio E is plotted as ordinate and log sigma bar is plotted as abscissa. Once we conduct laboratory testing on the sample, the curve is ABC is obtained. This curve is represented as KU and is called as laboratory curve. Point C is corresponding to void ratio of 0.4 E0, where E0 is the initial void ratio in the field. Now, Schimmertmann established that the laboratory virgin curve intersects the field consolidation line at void ratio of 0.4 E0. That means field curve must pass through C. Point D again represent initial void ratio in the field, that is E0, and initial overburden pressure in the field, that is point D represent actual condition in the field. So field curve must also pass through point D. Once a sample from the field is extracted, the void ratio of the sample remains constant, but effective overburden pressure of the sample reduces gradually from sigma naught bar to E naught. This process is represented by line E naught D. Now in laboratory curve, the portion AB represents recompression curve because it represents effective pressure below the actual initial pressure in the field. Portion BC represent virgin compression curve. Now if we extend linear portion of the curve ABC backward, it will intersect the line E0D at point E. E lies on left hand side of the D. In normally consolidated soil, E always lies on left hand side of the D. From this we can establish that the soil is normally consolidated. Now by joining point D and C, we can obtain field consolidation curve. It is represented as KF. The slope of this line DC is equal to the compression index of the in-situ soil. If the sample is remolded and again tested, the compression curve KR is obtained. The slope of the KR curve is somewhat smaller than that of KU curve. However, the downward extension of KR line also intersects the horizontal line drawn from point 4 E0 bar at point C. Now we will discuss field consolidation curve for pre-consolidated soil. This graph is again plotted as void ratio, E as ordinate, log sigma bar as abscissa. Curve ABC is obtained during laboratory testing of sample extracted from the field. This curve is represented as KU, that is laboratory curve. This is the unloading curve obtained during laboratory testing, and this is recompression curve. This is also obtained during laboratory testing. Now point C is again corresponds to void ratio of 0.4 E0, where E0 is initial void ratio in the field. Point D represent initial void ratio in the field and initial overburden pressure in the field. Sigma C is pre-consolidation pressure. If we draw a vertical at line E0D, it will intersect at point F. If we extend the linear portion of the curve ABC backwards, it will intersect the line sigma naught d at point E. Now we will discuss field consolidation curve for pre-consolidated soil. This graph is again plotted as void ratio, E as ordinate, log sigma bar as abscissa. Curve ABC is obtained during laboratory testing of sample extracted from the field. This curve is represented as KU, that is laboratory curve. This is the unloading curve obtained during laboratory testing, and this is recompression curve. This is also obtained during laboratory testing. Now point C is again corresponds to void ratio of 0.4 E0, where E0 is initial void ratio in the field. Point D represent initial void ratio in the field and initial overburden pressure in the field. Sigma C is pre-consolidation pressure. If we draw a vertical at line E0D, it will intersect at point F. If we extend the linear portion of the curve ABC backwards, it will intersect the line sigma naught d at point E. Now, it is here point E is lying at the right side of the point D. In previous case, point E was at the left side of the D. In case of pre-consolidated soil, point E always lies at right hand side of the point D. It is obvious that there is recompression of the soil from a pressure of sigma naught bar to the pre-consolidation pressure sigma C bar. A smooth curve DG is drawn parallel to the recompression curve. It intersects the vertical at sigma C bar at point G. Now, point G and C are connected by a straight line. So, the curve DGC represents field curve. It is denoted as KF. For pressure between sigma naught bar to sigma C bar, the relevant index is the recompression index CR. And for the pressure more than sigma C bar, it is the compression index CC. The third case is of under-consolidated soils. In areas of recent landfills, sometimes the soil is under-consolidated. That means it has not reached equilibrium under the effective overburden pressure sigma naught bar. For such soils, pre-consolidation pressure sigma C bar is less than overburden pressure. Thus, sigma C bar is less than sigma naught bar. The total compression when such soils are subjected to external loads is equal to the sum of the compression due to overburden pressure till equilibrium is reached and the additional compression due to external loads. Thus, delta E equal to delta E1 plus delta E2, where delta E1 is decrease in void ratio due to sigma naught bar and delta E2 is decrease in void ratio due to applied pressure as found in normally consolidated soils.